Here's another quick hit of today's top stories, and we'll know within the next 2 weeks when Western Australia's border will finally reopen. Mark McGowan made the announcement as WA recorded 62 new COVID cases, 48 of which were locally acquired. The border was due to reopen 10 days ago, but the Premier changed his mind.
No doubt we'll reach an announcement sometime during February. By the time we reopen the interstate and international borders, we'll be one of the highest vaccinated places in the world.
Canada's PM is taking extreme measures to crack down on anti-vax mandate protests that are now in their third week. Justin Trudeau has invoked the Emergencies Act for the first time ever, which will allow the government to stop people from gathering in certain locations. The move follows the week-long blockade of Canada's most important border crossing.
This is about keeping Canadians safe, protecting people's jobs, and restoring confidence in our institutions.
A new national scheme has been established to recycle Australia's used batteries. BCycle is setting up 2,300 collection points across the country so batteries can be disposed of properly. There's believed to be about 150 million batteries rolling around our homes.
Australians buy enough batteries every year to wrap around the earth 2.3 times. They're absolutely critical metals and they're non-renewable, so we can't afford to be throwing them away.
And there's been plenty of support for Grace Tame after someone lifted this old photo from her Insta account and started circulating it. She was about 19 when it was taken. Immigration Minister Alex Hawke denies the federal government leaked it. But Grace didn't miss the chance to have a dig at the PM, referencing that 60 Minutes interview, tweeting, "All right, I confess, we were doing a cover of April Sun in Cuba on the Obo."
I mean, I think Grace Tame has a lot to answer for. I mean, this Bong photo services and all of a sudden Snoop Dogg's doing drugs. I mean, I don't know. You got to join the dots on that one.
Oh, it was a gateway for her.
It really
How
was.
How does she have the energy to keep firing up and firing back?
They find new ways, don't they? Just to embarrass themselves.
I know. Absolutely.
It's strange.
Snoop Dogg scored a new gig. Speaking of Snoop Dogg, fresh from starring role at the Super Bowl, he's been named co-host of the US version of Eurovision alongside Kelly Clarkson. The American Song Contest will run live over 8 weeks with 56 competitors from all 50 US states, 5 territories and Washington, D.C. And is this the most extravagant school meal ever? A mum in the US made this special lunchbox for her son's golden birthday. Pictures posted online show it included a lobster wrap, golden biscuits, and a golden can of fizzy drink. It even came with gold cutlery, a gold straw, and gold sandwich wrap. So cute. I've had to up my lunchbox game. My son, who's 14, decided it was time to confront me last year and said, "Could I stop putting tiny teddies in his lunchbox?"
That happened last year. You still putting them in there?
14 and still thought, that's what a 14-year-old wants, some tiny teddies. But he liked them when he was four, you know?
I'll have them. Yeah. Have you got spares?
You're not popping open some tiny teddies.
If you give them to me,
like,
I will.
I feel so embarrassed that I thought...
Tiny teddies are still big in our house. I don't have them, but tiny. I still have a TikTok biscuit. Yeah, TikTok biscuit.
TikTok biscuit is awesome.
We love TikToks.
But again, I don't think a 14-year-old at school wants to open Tiny Teddies and a TikTok biscuit.
And a roll up.
A roll up in a juice box.